Hi everyone, this is Radhika here again. I hope you all are safe and healthy during this time. And this video is going to be about three things to watch out for during the holiday season with the narcissistic family. So the first thing is narcissistic rage. So this is especially if you are dealing with an overt narcissist, because overt narcissists have their main energy in operating in the world is of anger and frustration. That's because a part of them is extremely angry always at the world, and my interpretation of this is because they have been wronged in some way in their childhood and they haven't really healed from it at all. So they don't become covert. What happens is a part of them just becomes extremely against the world, and so they are basically like you can say like a nihilist, but maybe all of them don't go all the way to nihilism, but a part of them is definitely very self-sabotage, nihilist kind of a part of them, you know, which is very apparent everywhere. And so that part comes out a lot in like anger, and especially during holidays it comes out as rage, because it's hard for them to balance themselves when there's happiness outside and irritation, frustration and anger inside. So they can't really like it becomes a very imbalanced environment for them, so they try to make the outside frustrating or angry, because that is how they feel inside. So that is if you have like an overt person in this dynamic. The second thing you should watch out for is if you have someone covert, then it will be all the passive aggressiveness that you have to watch out for. So it's like the snide comments, snide remarks, all the putting you down subtly, putting themselves up subtly or non-subtly, all the drama, all the gossip, all the blame games, etc. So when you're dealing with a covert, you have to watch out for a lot more things than when you are dealing with an overt. But then again, we can't really compare the two, they are very different. But just like with coverts, it's all very like hidden, subtle, you know, not out there in your face, but you will feel it. If you are actually in that circumstance, you will feel that something is off with this environment. And then the third part is the third thing to watch out for is your own overwhelm. So if you have been with a narcissistic family and maybe you awakened to like their dysfunction quite early in your childhood, it's probably made you an introvert, because when you were a kid, you picked up so many things from your environment that it kind of made your nervous system very finely attuned. And so it just became so finely attuned that now you pick up on things very easily. And when your nervous system is finely attuned, it makes you... It helps you become overwhelmed very easily, because you notice a lot of subtleties which other people might not notice. And because of that, when it's an environment where a lot of things are happening, your nervous system gets overwhelmed by all the stimulus that's coming at you. So that's another thing to watch out for, that you might feel very overwhelmed when there's lots of people around, lots of music, lots of loud talking going on, etc. So yeah, that is the third thing to watch out for. And what happens is when it becomes like a good mixture of these first three points, it becomes a very good like, you know, a cocktail for all of your wounds getting triggered very quickly, because you're overwhelmed, because you're not rested enough, and because all of these things are happening in your surroundings. It becomes like any human who is in this condition will become very easily triggered, you know, by something that happens. And so a good like a tip for this is that if you know that you are going to be in this situation during the holidays, say you still visit your family or your family visits you or something like this is happening in your life, what you have to do is you have to keep a good routine going throughout the holiday. Keep your thoughts positive. Don't expect anything to change. You know, like if you're expecting a lot of change from your family, it's probably not going to happen. They probably are going to stay the same for the rest of their life probably. And of course miracles do happen, but we need to keep our thoughts more realistic than that. If they happen, that's good, so be open for miracles, but don't count on them. And yeah, keep your focus on good health and mental peace during the holiday time. And yeah, use all the resources at your disposal to help yourself. So yeah, that was this video. I hope this helps you in some way. And as always, I wish you all a lot of love and a lot of light. Thank you. Bye.